COVID mutations are at the top of our minds, but what implications do they have on our future health? Three variants of concern are spreading across the planet, and all three have now been identified in the United States. Medical experts are concerned that these new variants are more contagious and may worsen the pandemic. By nature, viruses mutate to live and live to mutate. So how does this translate to us? Each COVID infection increases the risk of new mutations that could make the virus more infectious or deadly. The U.S.'s top infectious disease expert, Anthony Fauci, said that even if the variant isn't deadlier, more infectious variants will kill more people. So when it comes to COVID variants, should we take even more precaution, and will the current COVID vaccine protect us? Let's bring in the director of the Vaccine Education Center at Children's Hospital of Philadelphia, Dr. Paul Offit. Welcome back, Paul.
Thank you very much. Good to have you.
Also joining us is infectious disease specialist, Dr. Monica Gandhi. Welcome, Dr. Gandhi.
Hello, thank you.
Dr. Gandhi, I think it's so important to sort of clear the air for everybody out there listening that mutations of viruses happen all the time. It's not necessarily something unusual. We see it with the influenza virus. Can you touch on that?
Yes, it does mutate like all RNA viruses do, but it's not as quickly as influenza. And it did mutate. And then the ones we keep on hearing about are likely the ones that are more, quote, fit, or they're just able to get around more. They're able to spread more quickly.
So Dr. Offit, it feels like we're constantly getting new information out about mutations. People are wondering if they're more dangerous, they're more communicable, that there might be even more higher rates of mortality that we're going to be seeing with these mutations. What are your thoughts about that?
The critical question is, and this is what you're asking, do those changes create functional differences? In other words, that the virus contagious or virulent, meaning more likely to cause severe disease, or most worrisome, that it escapes vaccine-specific or vaccine-induced immunity. So both the Pfizer and Moderna vaccines, which are messenger RNA vaccines, those studies were not done in South Africa, which is where that particular variant predominates. But the Johnson & Johnson product, which just announced its data this morning, was tested in South Africa. What they found was that the vaccine was 72% effective at preventing moderate to severe disease in the United States, but it was 57% effective at preventing moderate to severe disease in South Africa. So there was a reduction, but the good news is there, and I consider this good news, it was still really in the high 80% protection against severe disease, which is the kind of disease that caused you to go to the hospital, go to the ICU, or go to the morgue. So I do think, in general, I consider that relatively good news.